Alright, after this introduction to mixed precision training, in this video, let's actually try it out in practice and see if it can make our code run faster.
So we are going to take the code from Unit 8 and fine-tune the Distilbert classifier with and without mixed precision. Just to have a performance baseline, let me try this out without mixed precision. So this is exactly the same code that we already saw in Unit 8. So let me scroll down to the crucial part here in the code, the trainer setup, which is here. So we are going to train the model on one GPU, not using any mixed precision training. I added here a few lines of code for tracking the time that it takes. So here we are initializing the starting time or date stamp, and then we are fitting the model, capture the ending time, and then we print the difference between the ending time and the starting time, divided by 60 to get minutes, and it will tell us how long the training loop will take here. So let's run this and see what happens. So this will take a while until we reach the three epochs, so we can fast forward here and then skip to the results. Yeah, so once the training has finished, we can see it takes about 21.64 minutes to finish for the three epochs. And then, quickly looking at the test performance, we get 96% on the training set, 93% on the validation set, and 92% on the test set itself. So this is our baseline. Now we are going to modify the code and use the mixed precision training. So let's rename that and call that fine-tuning with automatic mixed precision float 16. So the only thing we have to change here is to add the precision argument, 16 mixed, and then train this network and see how long it takes this time. So this time it should be a bit faster, and as you can already see, the bar here fills much more quickly. So again, instead of waiting until this training finishes, let's skip ahead and look at the results. Yeah, this time it only took 7.24 minutes, which is about 3 times faster. So without the mixed precision training, we had about 22 minutes, and it's 3 times faster now. And also quickly looking at the accuracy here for the training set, the validation set, and the test set, it looks identical. So without suffering from any accuracy loss, we speed up our model here 3 times by just using 16-bit floating point precision, which is awesome. And as the last thing, we can also try out the brain floating point precision here. So let's change that to BF, and then we will also change it above. So here we now change it to BF16 for comparison, the last comparison here, and run this again. Yeah, so this time it took 7.6 minutes, which is slightly slower than before. And yeah, looking at the training accuracy, this went actually up. I think it was 96 before. This looks about the same, and this looks slightly lower. We had 92%. So you can see there are slight differences between float 16 and bfloat 16. So it's kind of like a hyperparameter depending on the application. But yeah, you can see in either case, we are able to speed up the training by a lot compared to not using any mixed precision training. So yeah, this is actually great.
So yeah, in this code example, we have seen how we can use mixed precision training to make our code run faster.